seasons of my youth. I recall a box of rags that someone gave us, and how my mama put the rags to use. There were rags of many colors, but every piece was small, and I didn't have a coat, and it was away down in the fall. Mama sewed the rags together, so in every piece with love she made my coat of many colors that I was so proud of. As she sewed, she told a story from the Bible she had read about a coat of many colors Joseph wore, and then she said, perhaps this coat will bring you good luck and happiness. And I just couldn't wait to wear it, and Mama blessed it with a kiss. My coat of many colors that my mama made for me, made only from rags, but I wore it so proudly. Although we had no money, well, I was rich as I could be. In my coat of many colors my mama made for me.
Beautiful. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. God bless everyone. Isn't that beautiful, that melody of Dolly? That's a real story in her life. Mine was my father, okay? And I was picturing my father in that, all right? My father was my mommy and my everything. And when she was mentioning our mommy, you know, I was thinking about my mom in heaven, because I found out I have a mother that had me when she died. And I adopted mother from my stepmother, one the best of the best to me from the group. And to me, that was my mommy, you know. And the reason my father was taking care of me constantly and giving me bath and comb my hair and do everything as a mommy, plus a farmer home, you know, countryman. Later, I found out after I was an adult that I didn't have no mommy. My mommy was dead when she had me. And that touched my heart to love my father more and more. I mean, at that time, when I found out the real truth, he was in heaven too. And when today, when I was listening to this beautiful melody of Dolly, I said, well, my mommy, because I serve the Lord. I know in heaven she was making something special for me. I know that. Because look what happened. God is using me. Even when I was a child, 5 years old, with my grandmother, she was like an army grandmother, very disciplined, no smile, but she tried to do the best with so many grandchildren. And one day she accepted the Lord in the country. Some country pastors, some of them without shoes, some of them dressed, some of them they don't look too dressed, but they have so much love in the word of the gospel to the country girl, to the country woman, with many grandchildren. At that moment, I was with my grandmother for a little while. She was training all of us to be good people in the future. Most of us, you know, her mother, all of them, some of them was broke marriage, and my grandmother used to open her arms to get us. Then I was there in that group, and I never forgot this. Then I want a hug. I want to embrace. I want something. But when my father used to come to pick me up, he used to do that. And I say, God, now I say this. In all that moment, I know somebody did a prayer for me. And I say, now my mother, even when she was dying, she would pray. I didn't know nothing about her because it was hiding all that mystery. And I never know nothing about her, just a little touch. Story, it's very short because it was hiding the truth. But she must be a good lady, a good woman, because I know. She did some prayer when she was dying. When she was having that girl, she could not even embrace. But I know she prayed that God can use me. I believe it with all my heart. No matter what I did the past, because I don't have the right direction. Only one person, my father, busy man. But look at that. God is using me in a mighty way because I love people with all my heart. I care so much for people. And that's the love of God since I was a little kid. And I believe with all my heart by listening to Dolly, it's not something that came so deeply in me, that the prayer for mommy, the mommy that I never met, the mommy that I didn't know no story about her, nothing about her. But I know she died when she had me. And she did a prayer, I believe it. And in heaven, she must be continue praying. Thank you. And thank you, my brother, that is here with me. Because this is a blessing to me to say these words, okay? Inside these words, inside my heart, so deeply. And God bless you all. This is Pastor Gloria Evangelist, first a servant of the Lord, a servant of God, a servant of everyone, a servant of all of you. I love you all. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to make a prayer. Thank you, Father, to be here in this station. Thank you for everyone that opened the doors, Lord. Thank you for the program that just left so precious people, so precious, embracing me and I embracing them, God, with that sweet and pure love and hugging for real. We need those hugs to embrace one another, Lord. And my brother right here with me. Oh, dear God, what a blessing. And the blessing that we have today, God, in the mission. My home is yours, a mission, Lord, that garden with children, that beautiful person that accepted the Lord she never did before. Even the father was a minister, the grandfather was a minister, but she never did. But today she did it, Lord. That's precious. And those two persons, female and a man, that couple, they refresh their salvation. That's the way we call hallelujah. Today it's like coming back for real. Hallelujah, to believe that you're coming soon. Hallelujah. And we have to be ready. Thank you for this privilege to be here. For Lola, for David, for Tom, the owner, for Bill, for every single person here, for my brother right here that he is with me, motivate me so much. I thank God for every second, hallelujah, of my life in this earth to do something constructive, to help someone and forget about me and think about others. And this program, never give up your dreams. Never, never give up on your dreams. It is a gift from God that the Lord used my father to put it in my heart when they sent me. Hallelujah, hallelujah. With no hope from the doctor. And he said to my father, bring that little girl and leave her alone. Let her die. Let her die. It's no hope. But my father looked at the doctor, that countryman with the green eyes and olive color, tall, elegant, hallelujah, character, passion, love, that little girl. And the story, he knew the story. Now I know the story. Hallelujah. I was not any little girl. I was a girl with no mommy. Now he's my mommy, my everything. And that was the piece of love in his arms. And the doctor said she's going to die. Bring her home. And he looked at the doctor, at his eye, and he said, my little girl will not die. My little girl will live. God have a purpose in her life. She will live. And he didn't believe what he saw, coma girl dying. He believed the love of God. Hallelujah. And here I am. Here I am in this microphone, bringing hope, kindness, and love. Hallelujah. And purity, my love. The purity, the love of God, agape. Care for one another. Hallelujah. Thank you, my dear people, for listening. Feels so good when you can empty your chest, hallelujah, and have all this inside of you. I've been doing this, the testimony about my father, but not so deep like today. God knows who I am. So glad because I can see people bringing their life and giving their life to the Lord. To me, that's number one. When I pray, I say, give me souls for the kingdom of heaven. Dear Lord, give me souls. Give me souls, sinners. That's one of my prayers deeply. Give me souls, children. They're lonely, dear God, with the parents coming to you. And dear Lord, bring me people to help me. Genuine people who care, respect children, respect the parents to help me. Because now I'm free in the ministry, dear Lord. Before I was not free, hallelujah. But now I'm free. I don't want to lose no time. I want to fight the enemy with love. Because that's the only way you can fight the enemy. It is with love. Agape love. The love of God. Not the worldly love. Hallelujah. But the love, agape. The love of God. John 3:16. That love in action in each one of us in the church. So much progress. So much program, good, wonderful, when those programs, hallelujah, represent the Lord. But the program outside getting the souls, Family Lonely, hallelujah. That number one program, bringing those sinners, hallelujah. That nobody want to talk to them because they're scared of them. Because love never scared of nothing, hallelujah. You just got there, hallelujah, where hate are. And you just showed the love of God, hallelujah. And you know what happened? Hate had to melt, hallelujah, melt. Because the love of God, it is more powerful than hate. And melt hate, hallelujah, when the instrument of the Lord, the servants of the Lord, the genuine purity, love, hallelujah, courage, halalabashika, I have to love and embrace those one. They involve around them with hate. But you say, I love you. You don't have to love me back, but I love you. Can I talk to you about the love of my life? The love of love, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, amen. God bless you all. Praise God. And Alicia, hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
Hi, Pastor Gloria.
God bless you, my dear sister.
God bless you. I love you.
Love you, too. Aww. You motivate me so much.
You motivate me. I was sitting here while you, I had my eyes closed while you were praying, and I was praying along with you, you know.
Aww. Thank you.
I just thank God for our connection spiritually.
Exactly.
You know, and the Holy Spirit, and it's true. You know, it's genuine, and I love that about you.
Thank you.
And I thank God for that.
Oh, I thank God for you. Oh, I think
you're a wonderful woman in Christ, and I love that.
Oh, thank you, my sister. But you are a motivator. You know that the first time how God, because you know my prayer. Yes, my sister. Then I ask the Lord to send genuine people with purity. Hallelujah! To work in the ministry with me, and everybody, it is a leader. Is that only me? Hallelujah, because I can see that leader in you. Jesus Christ is the leader. He's in you. He's the leader in me. We all are. We all are. Hallelujah. In degree, some degree, because the faith that each one of us have, that's it. That's it. But it's the same leader. It's the same Jesus. It's the same way. It's the same truth. It's the same light. It's the same love. Hallelujah. It's the same Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the ending, each one of us, the church. And it is in you, my sister. Hallelujah. In your children, your daughter, teenager, she shy. I call her Esther. I cannot stop that, calling her Esther.
You know, did you know she got in the truck today after Bible study, and she was like, Mommy, who's Esther? I said, Esther is someone in the Bible that God used mightily. So she came back to her room by herself, got the Bible, and started reading the book of Esther.
Oh, hallelujah.
Praise God. And I was standing in the kitchen cooking at the time.
Uh-huh.
I said, thank you, Jesus. She just did it by her, I came and got her Bible on her own.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Ooh, Saint, hallelujah.
That she made me smile. I was just like, and I'm happy on the inside about that. I thank God, thank you, Jesus, for that.
Yes. Your family belong to the Lord. Right there, you have the group, evangelistic group. How do you say evangelistic group?
Evangelistic, yeah.
Evangelistic. My English getting broken. Hallelujah. We love.
Yes, but that's okay. God is still using you. It doesn't matter.
But you remember when I fight with the lawyers, that I say, me, in English. They say, the first CD. I don't know if I told you this. The first CD, hallelujah, that I have it. I don't even want to show it to the people sometimes.
Yes.
It was in English, and I was shaking in the recording room once. And I was shaking. That's a long time ago, my brother. And I said, oh, my God, I'm doing it with broken English. And the Lord says, the Holy Spirit and my family and the Lord, my friends, every piece of broken English will be anointing because it is my love in every piece of that broken English that you called. I mean, he don't like that I called that, but I say, God, I'm sorry. That's human nature that coming out just like that, you know? Praise the Lord. Yes, that means the love of the Lord what matter, you know, genuine purity. Really, really, you care. He knows when you really care. He knows when you really care.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Praise God.
No.
What a precious.
I didn't hide anything from him.
Praise God. How is the kids? They want to say something?
Well, Aaron, she's sleeping.
So they look so tired today. They've been so busy. It's not this. They've been so busy.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
And then next week they're going to be really busy.
Exactly.
They start back school earlier.
But you're doing a beautiful mission, and I'm so pleased that you're part of the mission. And I'm so pleased because my prayer was God sent me genuine people that they love you with no limitation the way you love them. Genuine people, yes, that really care.
My prayer was to send me somewhere. I was just praying to God the whole time because I came to you. I didn't know I got, after I became an ordained minister, like I didn't know where to go next. Aww. And I kept praying, God, send me someone.
Hallelujah.
Send me someone.
We was praying.
Thank you, Jesus, for that.
Exactly, exactly. Oh, sis, here we are together, sisters together, just ordained to do the will of the Lord and be humble and servants first and second the title. And you know, and that's you, just exactly like me. And God put people together like that. Hallelujah. Yes, I want that. I want that. Praise God. Praise the Lord. And remember the lady that gave her life to the Lord today. Ooh, that was precious, sis. That was precious. And she's going to do her best to next week bring the whole family. The lady that she feels in her heart that something could happen to her, that God is warning her. I feel that too when I was praying for her in the in the store. She's a manager, sis, with a big, you know, title there and a responsibility. And she looked humble. She looked that she loved the Lord. But
you,
those things.
You can tell I got that feeling from her that she really does. She is.
Thank God she was with us. And God used all of you, the children. She was very impacted with the children, with you. And that's what I say, being the testimony of the genuine Christian. When people, for the first time, they know that person feels so good, not stranger. She didn't feel stranger at all. You either. Nobody feels stranger. Just one in Christ. The body, the way we're supposed to be, that body that become one for real, because that's the way we're supposed to be.
We're all connected.
Exactly, my sister. Exactly.
Through Christ, through Him, through the Holy Spirit, we're all connected.
Exactly, exactly, my sister. Then God bless you. Thank you for your call, and I love you so much.
I love you too. Enjoy this your show.
Okay, see, this is your show too. You're part of this, okay?
Okay.
God bless you. Bye bye. Oh, she's so precious. Isn't that precious? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is God. Love is love. And next week, I'm praying for somebody that I was expecting today. I need that help today to be there. And I trust this servant of the Lord because I don't invite everybody like that. Even if I need help. But this is a special person. And I want all of you that believe in prayer, even if you don't call, I hope you can call. But you pray for this precious man, young man. It is his shine. His shine. You can see Jesus through him. You can see Jesus. You can feel the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Praise God to him. And that trust comes from who? From the Lord. From the Lord. And pray then next week he can be there with the help of the Lord. Hallelujah. Helping hand to those kids like today. I need so much help today. And I was giving the message. I'm human and doing so much. Praise the Lord. And today I feel this. And I was thinking about my brother. Praise God. I love him. I forgave him. Oh, sure. That's love. You forgive right away. And you forget. Praise the Lord. God bless you all. Then we continue. Praise the Lord. And you that are listening to me today is the second day. It's not Sunday. Last week. And today was it's the second day. Okay. Pray that the program continue in the air. And pray because I want to continue to be, hallelujah, in this station because I love this station very, very much. And the people of the station, they care for others. To me, that's important. And this is a secular station, okay? But you know something? They show so much love. And to me, that's a beautiful example. And Lola, to me, she's my motivator as a woman. She motivated me. David Humble, hallelujah. A person who worked hard using his brain, his intelligence that God gave him, send a message, hallelujah. You know that's important. And when you read about Tom, the books and all those things that he do to help people, to motivate people, to help people, we have to pray for these people. We need them, and they, those ones that represent the station. And right now, the Lord opened a door that I can be, thank God for this, a second chance, hallelujah, representing the station as executive sales representative outside. I've been going and visiting people and leaving the package there, and you know something, a lot of good words from these business people toward the station. And I love that. Hallelujah. People that was here before, they want to come back again. But now we have to wait for 1 month, 1 month and a half, but they have thank God, hallelujah, the information with them, and good words from the heart for the station and the people that run in the station. That's powerful, okay? That's powerful. That's love. And that's they watching, they listening. Hallelujah, they smart people. The smart people listen, they work hard for the business, and they want their business in the station that they can trust. And I'm praying for that. And you pray for that too. And pray for the program continue here, that we can have some hours night and late for those lonely people. You're not alone anymore. Okay, I had to put emphasis more to this segment. You're not alone anymore. Anymore. No matter how old you are, how young you are, you're not alone anymore. You have the Lord. You have a Christian, hallelujah, person. You have friends that care for you. And I'm praying for that program, those type of programs, late at night, early in the morning, hallelujah, to get those people lonely, alone. Young kids walking with a radio, hallelujah, looking, searching, searching after music. They tired. They're looking for a message. They're looking for hope. They're looking for somebody that says something, hallelujah, that they can listen and bring hope to their life. Bring appetite to be alive, hallelujah. Tell them how important they are, how special they are, that Jesus Christ died for each one of them. That's powerful, and that's the reason they're so special, hallelujah, and we love them. And I want that type of program at those hours, because I feel this from the Holy Spirit deeply in my heart, hallelujah. And I want prayers that you never prayed before, that someday, not too long, we can have hours to bring messages to these lonely people, young kids, and all ages, hallelujah, praise God. They're not alone anymore, praise God, because they're going to have a message of hope to their heart. They're going to move them. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And we're going to continue. Now we're going to listen to some melody, okay? Then let's see some melody. And I've had to read the Bible. Thank you, Jesus. I'm so happy that I'm here.
I picked this one out for you. I thought you'd like it.
Okay. You have good taste, my brother. Sound good?
I think you'll recognize it.
Praise God. Yes, yeah, sound good. Sound good. Yes. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Thank you, Jesus.
When I know some wonder.
Thank you, Jesus.
Consider all the worlds I have made. I see the stars. I hear the roaring thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed.
When Christ shall come, which shall bow thy foundation.
Thank you, Jesus. Isn't that beautiful? Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to read, even with the music low, I'm going to read the Psalm 23. Today I was reading the Psalm 23, and I'm going to tell you this a message. The Lord was speaking to, and you heard last week about John 3:16, how people read it, even myself, I was just like, a, I don't know, fast, not so much emphasis at the word. Exactly with Psalm 23, and you know that. People just read it, just like that, when it's so much extract, and there's so much bread and water in Psalms 23, and it's not for the dead people. This is for the people who are alive here. The Lord let us know that He's our shepherd number one, even He used men and women, but He's number one shepherd. Hallelujah, the good shepherd. Praise the Lord. And I'm going to read it, and I tell you the truth, touch my heart all the time, but now I'm going to read it with more emphasis and more of reverence. That's the word, reverence. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the path of righteousness for His name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for You are with me. Your rod and Your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me In the presence of my enemies, you have anointed my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely, goodness and loving kindness will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Hallelujah! I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Who's that house of the Lord? Hallelujah! Who's that house of the Lord? Number one house of the Lord? The temple of the Holy Spirit. The temple's number one house with the church first, okay? With that temple. Then, hallelujah, the Lord used the tent. It's not the tent outside. Hallelujah. And we gather in there with one another. But responsibility will be individually. You always, always respect your individuality. To me, that's so important. Then you get together and we make a group. Then you get together and we make the assembly. One another, the body. Hallelujah. Like the kidney, the heart, you know, the ears, the nose. Praise the Lord, the body of Christ, the church. But we have to follow the step of the master, the shepherd, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. That dwell inside of you and me to the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. And for that, he paid the price. This was in the Old Testament. Hallelujah. And this shepherd became, hallelujah, under the grace, hallelujah, 100% man, 100% God, hallelujah. Pay the price in Calvary. At that cross, that, you know, John 3:16, thank you, Jesus. So powerful that he spoke to me, gave me a revelation. Then he gave me a message, how they play with John 3:16 like any story, any verse, and jump to many verses, and this verse, and the other verse, and the other, but they never stop. Really, 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 right there. Bring the extract of John 3:16. It's more than that, running all over. Hallelujah. That's the heart of the Bible. Praise God. Then Psalm 23 is, they go together. Hallelujah. Isaiah 53, they go together. Praise God. Let's just meditate. Go slowly. Preach even in the same verse. Sometimes jumping so much verses and people don't know what. You know, let's just bring the juice, bring the extract of that verse, hallelujah, with your life. What that verse did in your life. Say something. What this verse did in my life? Plenty. Plenty. Then we explain it this way. This shepherd, now in the grace, dwelling in me. By the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Praise God. Right there, you bring what? John 3:16. Praise God. They go together. Then, you want to get there? You go to Isaiah 53. Hallelujah. Oh, in his womb, in his tribe, by his stripes, we were healed because he, hallelujah, took all your iniquities. Hallelujah. Our transgressions. Hallelujah. By his stripes. Hallelujah. Praise God. We were healed, soul and body. Hallelujah. But first emphasis, number one, salvation. That means the healing of the soul. That's number one. Thank you, Lord. And I'm going to go now to the Spanish. Go so fast, it's not. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And we're going to say thank you, Lord. Ahora vamos al español. I thank God. Thank you, Jesus, for every person that Alicia, Lord, she's so precious in your heart. You know, she loves you so much. She's ordained minister. She want to use, hallelujah, that ordination. It is paper, but in your heart, it is more than paper. Because that paper represent her, represent us, dear God. And I ask you to bless her. And dear Lord, this precious person, Leona, that gave her life to the Lord, to you for the first time, dear God. Hallelujah. And she's in love with you, Lord. And you want to use her. And remember, dear God, that couple. Hallelujah, that pray and refresh the salvation. That's what we call refresh. Hallelujah, praise God. Saying, use me. Use me. Use me, Lord. Hallelujah, amen. Mis amados hermanos, estamos. Okay. En este momento. Okay, praise God.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm here.
Hello.
Hey. How you doing?
Oh, very good. God bless you. Just a punto. I was talking about the two refreshing salvation. Isn't that beautiful?
Right. Just in time.
It's praise.
Well, I'm calling for my prayer. You know, I'm calling to get my prayers
Hallelujah.
Yeah, my girl.
Amen, amen. Can you say something to everyone, the youth, everyone, to obey the Lord? What do you think when we remember the message today? I love that message because that got to me, you know, for all of us. It's not my brother, for all of us. The obedient, remember the obedient, to obey the Lord. Love, obey. He obeyed the Father when he came completely. What a beautiful pattern Jesus Christ left. Tell me about that obedience. When you pray that prayer, feel God. And when my I call my daughter, okay? I adopt both of you anyway. You my son too. Hallelujah.
Praise. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
Talk to me. Say something. You want a new life completely. Mm-hmm. Okay. And you, can you say to everyone how much you love the Lord, why you love him.
Oh, I love him. The universal. It's too much of a universal love. It's a crying love. It's a jerking love. It's a, you just don't understand type of love. You don't even know why you cry. It's a love.
His love is a passion.
You keep crying like a little baby.
Praise
you
God.
You don't know, man. It's the universal Father.
Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Exactly. And you know, my dear brother, because when we really, really deeply love the Lord, really, really, you know, we recognize that He is not a little God. He's a big God. He's a complete God. He created the universe. Amen. Universe. Mm-hmm.
Everybody's there. He's there. He's
hallelujah.
There. They don't know it.
Exactly. Exactly.
There's no one day. Right. You see everything. They say the least that you do in the kingdom is I mean, the least that you do is great.
Exactly.
You just don't know. It's the audience watching everything. They cheer
praise
for
God,
you.
Praise
good.
God.
And you got a good place when you come home.
Hallelujah.
Big room.
Exactly. But you know something? You always, I admire you, okay? Now I'm going to say I admire you. You're humble. Humbleness is tougher than toughness. People want to be tough, they cower to me. You know what I mean? Screaming! And this is the tough one, they the coward one to me. But humbleness, you have that gift from the Lord. The Lord, you know, he was so humble. So humble.
Right.
Hallelujah. Well, he could be the tougher one. You know that. He could be the tougher one. But he was so humble. Hallelujah. Humble, and he's still humble. And you know something, my dear? You're going to continue being that way. God going to use it. Remember the sister who came to the Lord? She said that you are evangelist. She called you evangelist already. That's God using her without even knowing. Hallelujah. She said that. So innocent, you know, innocent. And I love you. Embrace my dear daughter right there. She's there near you.
She wanted to know about the kids.
Okay.
With the kids. She wanted to listen to the service.
Exactly. I love both of you. I love you all. You know that. And you're in my heart. And take something that I put right there, okay? Praise the Lord. And you take care of yourself, okay? Love you. And I keep praying. But let's make a prayer, okay? Right now, Father.
Yeah.
Right here, God, this young man and the young lady, your God, they both today. They want the salvation to be refreshed. Hallelujah. Refreshed. I love that word. Because they love you, Lord. They want to give more and more and more to you because they know you gave it all for them, for all of us. Bless them in a special way, dear Lord. And use them, dear God. Use them in my ministry, God. They have doors open. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To be used, God. Not to judge them, but to be used for the glory of the Lord. They're young, God. And you calling soldiers. Hallelujah. A lot of David. A lot of Deborah. A lot of Esther. Hallelujah. To be used. A lot of David and Joseph. And they ready, dear God. Hallelujah. Thank you for this privilege, for this call, your protection, your blessing. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I embrace you in the name of Jesus, okay? God bless you.
I love you. God bless you.
Okay. Oh.
I love you.
Love you, too. I love you, too.
Big kisses and big hugs. They're so big.
I know. Thank you, Jesus. Oh. So precious, so precious. That's the love of the Lord. It's clean, it's pure. You see, it's holy, it's nothing. What a difference, you know, what a difference. Exactly, what a difference. God bless you. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, ciao. See you.
Okay, mommy, I'll see you again. Thank you, okay?
You're welcome, my dear son. You're welcome. See God you bless soon. You. Oh. Thank you, Jesus. God is God. God is God. The love of the Lord, you know, in action. El amor de Dios en acción. Gloria a Dios. They went to the service today. They was there. Those, you know, they refreshed their bow with the Lord. Praise God. And God have something special for this couple, I call. You know, we have to keep praying. And even this girl that accept the Lord today, she say about him. For the first time, he saw him. Say, he's like an evangelist. But just like innocent baby, you know, innocent. They came just like, yes. I said, this is God using her without even knowing, telling him. Because that's the way he's humble, very humble. And very smart. Very and always ready to help. Always ready to help. Praise God. And he need a lot of motivation. A lot of motivation, genuine, somebody that shine like a lot of my brothers, praise God. And it's a lot of need, and it's right there, somebody that really will embrace, hallelujah, embrace any person that go there and say, you're all right, we're going to help you, we're going to pray for you. You're not alone. You're not alone anymore. You're not alone anymore. Praise God. Y estamos, ¿verdad? En español, English and Spanish. I was saying that before, and I think I didn't repeat it too often, but English and Spanish is better. It's not this half an hour. And tenemos que darle gracias a Dios porque cuando venimos al Señor nunca estamos solos. Entonces tenemos que llevar el mensaje a todo el mundo de que nosotros tenemos la salvación, tenemos a Cristo, y nunca te sientes solo cuando tú tienes a Cristo. I want to say this. And today when I was in my desk and at the office, the Lord brought these thoughts because I'm not so good person. Hallelujah. My God is so good in me. Okay. Good in me. And what's about these people? Sometimes they feel so lonely. Christian. I'm talking about Christian because when somebody that doesn't have God, they sure they're going to feel lonely. God is not there. The best companion, number one. You have him, you have everybody. Then the Lord said this to me. Many times. I permit my people to be alone, not too many people around them. Like this, I can talk to them. Like this, they can talk to me directly. Like this, I can have a fellowship with them and prepare them for the call. Ha! Hallelujah. They can focus in me. I say, oh my God, because that happened to me so many times. I say, this is not, you know, that's it. Preparing for the ministry. If you are around too many people, how can I prepare? How can you listen to my voice? But when you are alone, you and me, big things will happen because I can communicate. I will communicate the message. I will prepare you. I will prepare you the way I want. I want. And I say, thank you, Lord. I you know, and I receive it for myself first. I tell you, because I mean myself. Asking so many questions sometimes about that. That's come natural because we're still in this body. This flesh is still here, you see. But it's so beautiful when the Lord say that. That means when Christian, servant of the Lord, hallelujah, the Lord is calling you for his mission. And remember this pastor, this shepherd from Psalm 23, he dwells inside of you through the Holy Spirit when you gave your life to the Lord. And he is preparing you. Hallelujah. This is the college, heavenly college, the best of the best. Hallelujah. The heavenly one. I'm calling about the divine college, okay? The Christian college right here from heaven to heaven with you. Heaven with you. Praise God. Divine, completely divine. Holy, holy, holy. Hallelujah. Had to be this communication, you and God, God in you. Hallelujah. The storm can be around, hallelujah, but the Lord, hallelujah, do something so special that he may use the wind outside be like music. Hallelujah. To combine the wind outside, hallelujah, hinda kibashaya, that he can put that music to your ears, that his voice is there, hallelujah, giving you the message. I'm preparing you. I'm preparing you for the fight. I'm preparing you for my mission in this earth. Listen to me. I am your teacher number one. Even I use men and women to be teacher. But when become teacher directly, the number one best of the best, when you have a call from above, is God, you, and God to the Holy Spirit. And he needs his space. You know the space? When you and God by yourself in your house, in your office, hallelujah. Then you say, but if nobody's coming, what happened? What happened? The Lord, hallelujah. The Lord training you. College, that beautiful college, that no one can take the place of that college. Hallelujah. When it's that anointing so powerful because he been with you, training you. Hallelujah. Passing troubles because the Lord fight with us in the way he don't want to do it because flesh want to fight that. But the best of the best, the Lord keep doing it. Keep doing it. He love you too much. He love you. He love you with no limitation. And he keep there. And he keep there preparing you for the fight. You're not alone anymore because the Lord is with you, Christian. Hallelujah. Preparing you for the ministry. You have a beautiful ministry in your life. Hallelujah. Beautiful ministry in your life. Use it. Use it. When somebody say, I need you, that's God open that door for you. Jump right away. That happened to me. Hallelujah. Jump right away. Praise God. Plus, when it's a ministry that's starting, hallelujah, praise God, like me, I was like doing ministry, but was private ministry. It's not the same. I had 2% in my head. Then I have 98 that I was dealing. People was getting saved. They was getting saved, but I don't have the freedom completely to bring the full gospel. Hallelujah, the way God wants. But now I'm free. Hallelujah. I will pay price in one way or another. I don't care. I have to say that with respect. Hallelujah. The Lord will provide my needs. If sometimes was with nothing in the refrigerator, I say, I'm going to fast. It's time to fasting. Hallelujah. And see it that way. And see it that way. Praise God. But I want to be prepared to fight the enemy and get those souls from him, those youths from him. Don't matter how old they are, how young they are, we're going to bring them to God. Hallelujah, the creator. But we have to be what? Hallelujah. Listen to his voice and that loneliness. You're not alone anymore. When you are a Christian, you're not alone at all. When you're not a Christian, you are alone. Hallelujah. But we're here to tell you, you're not alone anymore. When Jesus, you open your heart for Jesus, the shepherd of shepherds, he wants to dwell inside of you to the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Come to me, you that are tired. Tired. The Lord will give you rest. He's the only one. The good shepherd, the good shepherd, the table is ready for you. El buen pastor está preparando, aleluya. Y cuando tú te sientas solo, cristiano, eso es mentira del enemigo. Tú no estás solo jamás. Porque el Señor te está preparando para la misión. Te está preparando para el llamado que Él tiene para ti. Y el pastor de pastores, como estaba leyendo, gloria al Señor, en la misión, que tuvo un gathering. Entonces el Señor me dio ese tiempo, me está pregando conmigo acerca del Salmo 23, que se usa también como él me habló acerca de Juan 3:16, que se lee y sin rumbo, y no se le pone mucha importancia, porque ya es como una costumbre de leerlo rápido, ¡pum! Y da sed. Cuando tiene tanto jugo, cuando tiene tanto aceite, aleluya, y ese aceite, el shepherd, el pastor de pastores dentro, aleluya, que vive dentro de ti, que quiere hacer algo en tu vida y él quiere que te detenga y lo leas y tomes del jugo y tomes el aceite que tiene alabanza para prepararte a ti. Y esa soledad, cógete el Salmo 50, el Salmo 23, y en esa soledad que tú te sientes a veces, comienza a leerlo y a leerlo y a leerlo. Y Juan 3:16, y a leerlo y a leerlo y a leerlo. Te está preparando para la misión. Y entonces, pastores que se sienten solos, que se sienten así, ya sabes, haz lo mismo, pastor. Dios tiene grandes cosas para ti, tienes una responsabilidad grande, pero Dios quiere hacer algo en tu vida y quiere seguir usándote grandemente. Y tienes, llámame cuando desees al teléfono 727-210. Ese es mi teléfono de la misión, 210-7268. Ese es mi teléfono. I want to give it in English. If you want to call the mission, my home is a mission, praise the Lord, 727-210-7268 for prayer. You leave the message, I will call you back right away. I do that. And pray for you, praise the Lord. You need counseling, please call. Hallelujah. I'm there for you. Praise God. You have the call of God in your life, hallelujah, and you want counseling, you better call me because I've been through so much. Because the call of God in my life, praise God. Not everybody say, oh, so nice, Gloria. Not a sad. Hallelujah. You expect that. I get happy when somebody say, God, want to use me. I say, whatever I can do to help you, here I am. That's me. Here I am. so happy. He's not going to the word. He's not going to the bar to drink. He's telling me the good news. How can I not help him? Or even a church near me when I'm just starting my ministry right there where I live. Somebody, I think in the other door, I will be happy. I mean that. Because when somebody put a bar in another bar close to the other, they get happy. They don't even care. What about us? Hallelujah. We better bring the best message. Tenemos que traer el mensaje mejor que cuando un cristiano, Dios lo usa y lo llama, lo tenemos que respaldar. Eso no es de dirijarla ni para allá ni para acá, porque eso es negocio del Señor. El negocio es cuando hacen bares y un bar lo ponen aquí en Nueva York, en New York, I saw that. Un bar aquí, otro bar acá, just like that. Y ellos se van y se reparten, se dan las manos. Y ¿cómo va a ser? Entonces, the church, nosotros tenemos que hacer lo mejor. The we, the church, we have to do better. Hallelujah. In New York, I used to see that more than ever. A bar there, or a grocery store, and the other one, just close to the other side, and the people used to come and welcome them. Whatever you need, can you tell me? You know, I said, well, then we have to do the same thing, the church. Hallelujah, we have to do the same thing. That's the love of God in action. Praise God. Dice, esto es entonces, se viene el 23 del Good Shepherd, del buen pastor. Las acciones de buen pastor. Las acciones de Juan 3:16. Porque de tal manera amó Dios al mundo que dio a su hijo. Porque de tal manera amó al mundo. Aleluya. Que dio lo más lindo, lo más grande, su hijo. He gave his son. He got his son that he loved so much to the world to suffer. Aleluya. But he did it. Hallelujah. What a message. What a message. Praise the Lord. Then, hallelujah. Psalm 23. The shepherd. The good shepherd that came to the cross hanging there for us is powerful. We're going to put it in action. We're going to be grateful. Lo vamos a poner en acción. Todo esto pasaje y tanto brincar. One passage to another passage. And what happened? Did we put in action this verse that we read in so many? Hallelujah. Let's put in action. I want to put in action this one. I want to put in action John 3:16 with all my heart, all the days of my life. I want to put in action, hallelujah, every verse that I read and I stay there eating, drinking, hallelujah, embracing, hallelujah, meditating in the beautiful verse that is God speaking to me, sending a message, hallelujah, that I can share this message with others. El Señor está en ese verso. No me dice, no me avances corriendo. ¿Qué ha pasado con ese verso en tu vida? ¿Qué ha hecho ese verso dentro de ti? And the Lord say to me, stop, read it, eat it, drink it, digest it. What that verse that you're reading so fast is doing in your life, that's me, that's my word, that's my water, that's me, hallelujah. I want that verse alive in your life. Don't jump from one to another, to another, to another. What that verse did in your life. Can you tell me? Can you talk to me? What John 3:16 did in your life? Can you talk to me? Hallelujah. What the Psalms 23. Hallelujah. What a message did in your life. I know this so much in you. Because God loves you so much. The Lord spoke to me this message. That's why I'm sharing this way. Because I'm the first one. The Lord that I'm saying this. Because he spoke to me this. I was doing that. Innocent following everybody. Everybody doing it. Oh, how many? Oh, say, stop there. Stop there. Please me. Please me. Please me. Hallelujah. The enemy knows the whole Bible and he don't use it. No, you're different. The church has to be different. It's relationship that what I want. Hallelujah. Genuine, holy, holy, holy relationship with me. Love, love, agape with me. Hallelujah. Because I am love. I am love. Hallelujah. Let's be for real. Let's be for real. And please the Lord. Hallelujah. Please the Lord, number one. Be pleasers. Please, oh God. Hallelujah. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And everything will be all right. Thank you, Jesus. And remember, I'm praying for hours, early at night. Early, I'm sorry, late at night and early in the mornings. That is a miracle. God is a God of miracle. For the lonely people. And the segment, the topic is, you're not alone anymore. Estoy orándole, Señor, mi amada familia, cerca de horas tarde y bien temprano para un programa para la gente que están solo, que se quitan la vida, que no quieren vivir. Tenemos la historia que yo le he dicho muchas veces, que viene siendo este joven, muchacho jovencito, Gloria a Dios, David Mercado. Esa es parte de personas que yo conocí, Gloria a Dios, conozco a los padres. Y se quitó la vida. Un niño con talento. I heard he has so much talent. David Mercado, who killed himself in the juvenile jail. He killed himself, and I heard he has so much talent. He wasn't seeing that. I heard. That's why I want to put that, you know, pray for that, because when I do so many things, now I'm free. I'm not with the 2 feet in my head. Hallelujah. I'm now free. Thank you, Lord. Completely. Talent. Somebody with talent. Christian, we call David. Hallelujah. Oh, bring him busy. Use your talent. You sing poems, whatever it is. And make time for him. Dave will be maybe sitting here near me. Hallelujah. Also, making some calls to say, I want to be part of that. I have talent. Hallelujah. That's why we have to get many babies. So don't kill himself. The devil is not the winner. God is the winner, and he dwells inside of us. And we do it by action, love, action. Hallelujah, to help others. David Mercado estuviera vivo, hermano. Un pueblo oyendo un mensaje así, gloria al Señor. Él tenía talento. Él quería hacer tantas cosas, me dicen a mí. Talento. Y estaba, porque no lo oían, gloria al Señor. Pero cuando tiene alguien que lo oye, David Mercado, gloria al Señor, estuviera vivo por una voz de amor que le dijera, David, te queremos. Esos talentos son de Dios y te vamos a ayudar. Cristo te ama, gloria a Dios. Y entonces ahí tú pones Juan 3:16 y pones al Salmo 23 en acción en la vida de ese joven. Y hay muchos jóvenes como David Mercado que están esperando palabras de aliento. Y many youth, many, 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 like David Mercado, waiting for the word of hope. For a word of hope, of love, that he can feel that love to the radio. Hallelujah, that impact his soul inside. Hallelujah, that move him. Hallelujah, to do something constructive to his life and be prepared to help others too. Hallelujah, that's powerful. That's so powerful. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord, that I'm free now to do the ministry, Lord. The many years you've been calling me. Hallelujah, little by little, dear Lord, in my own step. Forgive me, my God. I ask God for forgiveness. Now, God, I'm here. When I have to be running, tell me I just do it, Lord. Hallelujah. When I have to walk, I walk. But when you say, Gloria, it's running now, dear Lord, I will do it. Go to the deep water, more deep and more deep and more deep, my servant. I will go to the deep water, to the deep water. Hallelujah, because I know you are my rescue. You are my savior. You are my everything. You are my friend. You will never, never leave me, not forsake me. Hallelujah, to those one that obey you and want to do your will. Obedient. Today I brought this, hallelujah, the message and the mission about obedience. Hallelujah. Oh, praise God, was a blessing. Look, people getting saved. Hallelujah, obedient. Let's obey. Let's be doers. That's obedient and love, obey. This is Gloria Trevino, Pastor Gloria Trevino. And remember, the following week, Sunday, from 6 to 7, esta es la Pastora Gloria Trevino, Gloria Señor, poquito español, ¿verdad? Entonces, el próximo domingo, y oren ustedes, hermanos, porque necesitamos personas que nos apoyen, Gloria Señor, para seguir hacia adelante. Y I visited so many people this week representing the station. How many minutes? Representing the station, good. Representing the station, I have some of them here. Then I want to say it fast. And one of them know Lola. I was happy. Hallelujah. Praise God. And this one, Georgia Optical. Yes, in Clearwater Plaza. And he likes the station too. And this other one, Precious. And I say, this is America to me. They was laughing. There is Sunset Scooters. The Sunset Scooters sales, service, and rental at Doe. Be tell her he used to have an ad here. I heard. Now he stopped. I said, you're welcome. Come on. And he's waiting, okay? And other people, the next will remind me that I'm going to bring, because they waiting maybe for 2 months more things that to be in the station. And I'm so thankful. And dentists, I have some dentists too. Next week, praise the Lord. God is working. God bless the station. Pray for this station, okay? And God bless you. God bless you, my brother. Love you. This is Pastor Evangelist Serving First. Gloria Trevino Flores, I see you next week. And call 727-210-7268. That's the mission. And I will answer, okay? Please, I will answer. God bless you. Que Dios le bendiga.
Que Dios nos bendiga. Aleluya.
Just remember what to do. Reach out to Jesus. He's reaching out to you.
I love that one. What a message.
Is the life you're living?
Thank you, Jesus.
Filled with sorrow and despair.
Can I say this fast? Can I say this fast? Okay. I want to let you know about the garden that we have in 715 South Lincoln Avenue, Clearwater Apartments F12. I will be there with all the ministry staff and love. Remember, the love of God. I welcome each one of you. 727-210-7268. God bless you. I love you all in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Discouraged, just remember what to do. Reach out to Jesus. Come on and reach out to Jesus. I said to reach out to Jesus. He's reaching out to you.
WTAN, Clearwater, Tampa Bay. WDCF, Dade City, Tampa Bay. WZHR, Zephyr Hills, Tampa Bay. Listen.